And this is in the tune of da 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 da. I think it's Good King Wenceslas. Wenceslas. So here we go. Spring has now unwrapped the flowers. Spring has now unwrapped the flowers. Day is fast reviving. Life in all her growing powers towards the light is striving. All the world with beauty fills, gold the green enhancing. Flowers make glee among the hills, set the meadows dancing. Through each wonder of fair days, God Himself expresses. Beauty follows all His ways as the world He blesses. So as He renews the earth, artist without rival, in His grace of glad new birth, we must seek revival. Praise the Maker, all ye saints. He with glory gird you. He who skies and meadows paints, fashioned all your virtue. Praise Him, seers, heroes, kings, heralds of perfection. Brothers, praise Him, for He brings all to resurrection.
Thank you, Laura. And I just broke my glasses. Spirit is amazing.
Do you need a pair?
No, I'm good.
No?
Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to Unity Spiritual Center of Vero Beach, where our mission, teaching, loving, inspiring people to be all that they are created to be. Reverend Laura Gist, who was supposed to be here today, had a medical emergency, and we were holding her husband and her in our prayers. So let's breathe that in for a moment. Send her amazing, loving energy. So today, giving our lesson is Dr. Leslie Havidet, the president of our Board of Trustees. Leslie is a licensed mental health counselor, psychotherapist who has practiced in private practice for over 20 years, since moving to Vero Beach with her husband, Larry, in 1999. Leslie was at St. Edward's School for 9 years as a lower middle school guidance counselor and continued doing wellness workshops with the HERO program, helping everyone respect others, until last year when COVID made big groups and students and meetings impossible. Leslie has been a prayer chaplain since 2017, started our first Sunday Unity Meditation, our Labyrinth Walk, in 2019. She also started the New For You boutique that same year, where jewelry is recycled to happy new owners with all proceeds benefiting Unity. Thank you. And Faye is going to read the daily word.
We have the opening prayer first. After I get the prayer. Good morning, everyone. Okay, so I would like everybody here and at home to take a deep breath, settle into your heart center, and invite love into your heart. We know that God is all there is, and that God is unconditional and everlasting love. Divine love is broad and unlimited, a universal and harmonizing power. We also know that we are one with God. We are all that God is. Our life All life is God's life. We know that there is not a spot where God is not. We are the manifestation of God's love. We affirm love because love is who we really are. Nothing can separate us from love. This is our truth. As Jesus said to his disciples after the Last Supper, love one another as I have loved you. We demonstrate love through our actions, words, and thoughts about others. As we go through our days, we find love in all we see. We release judgments and expectations of others. We recognize the presence of love in all people and in all things. We see God in everything and everyone. We recognize that love is within us and share it with the world. As we walk in love, we radiate love to all of us around us. We are a powerful presence for love on this planet. We just simply remember to love. We give thanks for all of the wonderful expressions of love in our lives. We give thanks for the wisdom to follow love's guidance. We gratefully claim and accept the power and presence of love in our lives. Accept that we and all of God's creations are love in expression. And so it is. Amen.
Good morning. The daily word today is imagination. I imagine limitless possibilities. In childhood, my imagination helped me see fascinating shapes and wondrous creatures in cloud formations. Picking up a twig, I might have pretended I held a wand that could give me magical powers. An ordinary packing box could become a vessel to sail on or under the seas, an aircraft to fly higher than mountains, or even a spaceship I could fly to explore the stars. Much more than whimsy, imagination is a potent spiritual tool. I use my imagination with intention to give shape to my dreams and goals. Although my childhood may be a memory, I am grateful that I can still use my imagination to create the life of my dreams as I envision possibilities beyond the reality I know and the world I see. And from Luke 10:24, for I tell you that many prophets and kings desired to see what you see, but did not see it, and to hear what you hear, but did not hear it. Imagination. I imagine limitless possibilities.
Good morning again, everyone. This song is going to take us into meditation, so you can prepare yourself during the song. Close your eyes, ground yourself, and just hear the music. Alone, as I draw close to you,
You draw close to me, my loving friend who's always there and knows my every need. In the
Before we start the meditation, I just want to share how full my heart is with gratitude and love, looking out on the labyrinth, seeing two beautiful boys walking their meditation out on the labyrinth. And last Sunday, we had First Sunday again for the first time in a year. First Sunday at Unity is a meditation and labyrinth walk, and we had 10 people. So I invite all of you to come next month. In May, the first Sunday. So now we'll begin our meditation. And just take a nice, great, big, deep breath. Letting your shoulders drop down away from your ears, knowing this is our time to create that space of grace. And we do that by letting go and relaxing. And as we love and bless our body temple, we allow ourselves to relax from the top of our head all the way down to our toes. With our attention on our feet, we send love and thanks to our feet. Thank you, feet, for every step you've taken for me. Thank you for leading me back to making better choices, to the right path. Thank you for helping me to take a stand for what I believe in. And now bringing that relaxation all the way up your legs, rejuvenating your knees and your hips all the way up into the core of your body, and especially your heart. See beautiful waves of gold light flowing in and around and through your heart. This precious heart that beats us and keeps us alive. That source energy, breathing us, beating our heart, connecting us to that beautiful energy. and breathing, relaxing our arms and our hands. And with our attention on our hands, we send love and thanks to our hands. Thank you, hands, for handling so much in my life. And I now affirm that I can handle anything that comes to me with grace and ease. And now I relax my face and I smile, knowing that at any moment during the day, I can move myself into the center place of stillness and silence. Feeling ourselves go deeper and deeper into that center place, we relax with grateful hearts. And today we picture the most perfect pink rose all around our heart center. Imagine taking in the fragrance of the sweetness. Seeing that sweetness and the beautiful colors radiating out to every cell, every fiber of our wonderful, miraculous bodies. And as we relax, we know that we can release anything or anyone, including our own thoughts, feelings, and habits that do not serve our highest good. And we release anything that we don't need now. As we enter into that secret, sacred sanctuary, that upper room that we have within us at all times. As we enter our sacred sanctuary, we feel more and more peaceful. We feel our hearts opening. And we are so grateful for this day, for seeing little boys walk on a beautiful labyrinth in a beautiful garden. And breathing. As we relax and release, we remember and recognize our true identity as the wave is one with the ocean. I am one with God. God loves me in this moment. And because of that, I can love myself, forgive myself for mistakes, love my journey, knowing all of that has brought me to this perfect present moment. The same God that made this miraculous earth, made all of the oceans and all of the galaxies, made me. So I am precious. As I become aware of my presence, I make myself available to infinite presence. in this present moment, this holy, holy moment. I am one with God. Just breathing and taking that in. Resting in that truth. And now, centered in our hearts, allow yourself to picture Mother Earth, that big, beautiful, magical marble. Send love and compassion to everyone, every sentient being on this earth. Knowing whoever needs healing, compassion, understanding, forgiveness is receiving it now. And we are so grateful. We are so grateful to live a purposeful life. Knowing that in meditation and prayer, energy follows thought, and we can make a difference, a positive difference. As we come together in this spiritual community, either here in the sanctuary or with us at home, we feel our hearts connecting in love. And we know that we are never alone when we connect with each other in that heart space. Envision that beautiful pink rose in your heart center being sent out with streams of golden and white light, blessing this community, blessing our country and the whole world. And now we know that everything we send out comes back to us. So feel the waves of love coming back to you now. Brilliant rays of light around you and into you. Feel your body filling up with this love and light. Every cell, every fiber, every part of you. Part of you that is visible and the part of you that is invisible, filling up. Feel the fullness of that love and the joy that comes with it. Like a bubbling, joyful fountain. And now, if there's anyone or any issue that you're concerned about, see them receiving the waves of light, of love, of healing, of peace. We certainly hold that for Reverend Gist and her husband. and now preparing to come back into the room. Feeling loved, feeling filled and grateful and joyful. We come back ever so gently and slowly. Aware of our bodies, blessing our bodies again. Being willing to carry that big, beautiful pink rose in your heart. Feeling the love and radiating the love. And now taking a nice, great, big, deep breath and coming back. Thank you.
I almost said thank you, Reverend Leslie, for that awesome meditation. Thank you, Leslie, for that awesome meditation. Everywhere I go, all the places that I've been, every smile's a new horizon on a land I've never seen. There are people around the world, different faces, different names, but there's one true emotion that reminds me we're the same. Let's talk about love. From the laughter of a child to the tears of a grown man, there's a thread that runs right through us that helps us understand. As subtle as the breeze that fans a flicker to a flame. From the very first sweet melody to the very last refrain, let's talk about love. Let's talk about us. Let's talk about life. Let's talk about trust. Let's talk about love.
Let's talk about love.
And the greatest gift of these is love.
Is love, yes. Thank you so much. And so much love and thank you for every week you and Peter and Betsy Jo just show us love. And what was it that a Reverend Johanny said, when you sing, you pray twice, and when you dance, you pray three times?
Yeah.
I love that. So, Reverend Gist, we are sending you and your husband lots of love and healing hugs. At the last minute, we had to decide what to do. And I volunteered to do this, although I have never done this before. I've done other parts of the service, but I've never done the lesson. And the reason I was willing to do it is, in the last year of COVID, I have stepped out of my comfort zone over and over and over again. Just feel the fear and do it anyway. And as Reverend Juan said, we grow the most on the edge of our comfort zone, on the outer edge. As my adorable fighter pilot husband would say, no guts, no air medals. So Larry, this is for you. And I'm glad he's not here. So one of the things that, as I was sitting in the parking lot of Sam's waiting for Larry to come out, and I got the text from our wonderful Barbara Petrillo, who plans all of the services and arranges it, we need an opening prayer, we need a meditation, we need a lesson. And I instantly, without thinking, wrote back, I can do it. And I'm like, what? What did you just do? That's not a good thing. And then I realized, well, I keep asking, what is mine to do? And the universe keeps answering me with all kinds of wonderful things. So today we're going to talk about seeing clearly. And the reason we're going to do that is because I'm not seeing clearly. In the last couple of weeks, seeing has been a real issue for me. I got cataract surgery on this eye. So if I start doing this and this and this, it's because one eye has had a cataract removed and the other hasn't. And there is a connection to what I'm going to talk about today with the donut hole. And now by now you're thinking, is she completely crazy? Seeing, not seeing, and donut holes, but I will bring it all together hopefully soon. So way back in 2019, when I first got on the board, I guess it was my initiation, the board asked me if I would please come up and talk about consistent giving. Nobody really wants to talk about consistent giving or asking for money, but I dug down deep and I thought, well, why is it that I love Unity so much? And it's because when I'm here with like-minded people, people see me. Remember the movie Avatar? When the Na'vi see each other, they say, I see you. And that's how I felt at Unity. I also felt going on the board that it was like a parent having the first child. It was just like, oh my gosh, my love is so deepened now. I'm because of the responsibility, giving more. And I really started seeing that the more I gave, the more I received, and that my eyes were getting more filled with love all the time. So that was back pre-pandemic. And we have gone through a lot this last almost year. I hope you really appreciate everything that you've gone through and that you pat yourself on the back and say, you know, I've done a pretty good job. I'm still here after all. So remember the days of hugging and kissing and no mask? How did you see it when we first got shut down? I remember very well sitting in my meditation spot, and I thought, wow, this is really happening. I could be scared. But then I remembered the magic question that I always use with clients. And the magic question is, what do I need to think in order to feel better about this? And of course, our perception definitely colors our feelings. How we see things really matters. So how did you see it? Do you remember way back a year ago in March? There were so many reactions. Because I deal with people who have problems, People who are vulnerable felt it much more. Have you changed this last year? I remember sitting in the living room in March of 2020 thinking, this is weird, but I'm thinking Mother Earth is saying, I've had it with you people. You go to your room and be quiet and think about it. I actually did. Thank you for laughing. That's what I thought. And then I felt like I'm not being reverent enough there. You know, this is really serious, Leslie. But gosh, all the airplanes are shut down. It is going to be better for the Earth. And then I just started watching people coping and being very, very creative. How have you changed this last year? One of the things that this has done for us is that we know that we are non-local beings and that we don't have to be with each other. Yes, it's wonderful to see each other, but we can connect, and we're connecting in new, amazing ways. We can have a Zoom church meeting every night. So one of the things that I did is last November, I took the class, The Eye of the Storm, with our wonderful transition specialist, Elizabeth Longo. And that book explains, and those of you who have been through hurricanes will know, that there's a storm, but in the center, there is an eye of the storm that is completely peaceful. So we met on Zoom every week. I think there were about 15 of us. And because I'm a foodie, very soon the eye of the storm turned into the donut and the donut hole. Because I can see a donut, and the hole is part of the donut, but it's a space, it is invisible. So if you will bear with me, if you think about the donut, it can be any kind of donut you want. If you think about the donut, that's the physical, that's what we can see. But the invisible, that center place, is there and it's invisible, but it's just as important. It forms almost the structure for the donut. And I love to think about the donut hole, W-H-O-L-E, that wholeness in our center. And this symbol works for me. I use it all the time. And the more I see from the place of the eye or the donut hole, when I'm in that place and I see from that place, everything looks different and I can handle things. In Matthew 6:22, we read, "If therefore thy eye be single, thy whole body shall be full of light." I'm going to read it again. If your eye is single, your whole body shall be filled with light. That's very easy to say when we're here in church and we're meditating and we're praying. But what about the donut dilemmas? All the things that we deal with. The broken dishwashers, sick children, lost car keys, a sick spouse, scheduling a COVID shot or not deciding whether to not do it. All those donut details. So over the last year, I find myself repeating things more and more to people. And one of the things is to ask better questions. What do I need to think in order to feel better about this? Well, immediately, I always think, I don't know what I don't know. So way back in March, as I sat on my couch thinking that Mother Earth was sending us a message, I thought, I don't know what I don't know. And I immediately think of that wonderful story of the farmer whose son comes home and all the neighbors, I know you've heard it a million times, but I love it. The neighbors say, oh, you're so lucky. And the farmer says, maybe, maybe not. And the horse kicks him, the son, the first week. And the neighbors say, this is so tragic. This is horrible. And the farmer says, maybe, maybe not. We just don't, and it goes on like that. We just don't know. So I've asked clients to ask better questions. And one of the things, the visuals that I have used over and over is that famous picture of Daniel in the lion's den. Do you remember it? It's a round prison and there's light streaming down and Daniel is in the center and all the lions are in the shadows. And I've said to clients and many people, what are you focusing on? If you keep your eye on the light and let it fill you, you don't have to be so worried about the lions. So every minute we have a choice. Is it going to be the light or is it going to be the lions? One of the things we know is that fear cripples our immune system. And I've explained over and over, think of two rooms, the sympathetic system, fight, flight, freeze. And down here is the parasympathetic, rest, digest, heal and feel. So how do I get to that state, the survival to the thriving? Lots of ways. Walking on a beautiful day, meditating. The easiest way is just breathe with an intentional breath. An intentional breath is different than just regular breathing. It is thinking just three times, just exhaling all the way out through whistle lips, closing your lips, breathing nice and big and holding it. And they've done research that has shown that if you, at the top of your inhalation, give thanks for something or someone, it even affects your system more. So one of the things that I'm constantly telling people is be here now. But what if, what if? And I say, are you okay right this minute? Yes, but, and my answer, I wanna say, get your big butt out of it. Just be here now. No. Or, you know, as they say in Star Wars, I think they said, there's no try. You either do it or you don't. Being in the present moment, God is now, reminds me of the beautiful garden. And if you haven't been out to this area right here, the Raines family put that garden in with the most beautiful etched stone that says, God is now. Please stand by that garden. And thank you, Phil. We love you. We miss you. So recently I had cataract surgery, and the next day at the post-op checkup, the eye surgeon announced, oh, you have a scratched cornea. And I went, what? Yeah, you have a scratched cornea. I said, how did that happen? I asked, and his answer was pretty vague. He said, well, it happens. As I left his office, he reminded me that I'm scheduled for the second surgery, and he said reassuringly, well, we'll be sure your left eye is good before we do surgery on your right eye. And I was just like, are you kidding me? I think that goes without saying. So just by chance, a few days after that, I was trying to not be upset. I was trying to ask the question, what do I need to think in order to feel better? I talked to a good friend I haven't talked to in a long time, Vicky. And she said, Leslie, I had the same thing happen to me with my cataract surgery. In fact, it's been 2 years and I haven't had my second one. They scratched my cornea. And she said, what did they do with you? And I said, the doctor put a contact in to seal it and to protect it and numb it and help it heal. And she said, oh my gosh, my doctor didn't do that. He didn't put any contact in. And I suffered for 3 days. I was in pain so much. So I had a new perspective about this. So I started thinking, how can I think about this? And I was so grateful for not being in pain, not having to take drugs for 3 days. And I thought, you know, it's so interesting. We have these old ways of seeing things, and they're sort of like the cataract, adding until we can't see new ways. And we can use love as our healing contact to pop in and see things differently. So when the outer eye is scratched and we're not seeing clearly, we can put on that corrective, loving lens and see with fresh eyes. This is called spiritual vision, just making the choice to keep our eye on the light and to love more. So we stop and at any time and step into the holy moment. We connect to the loving presence. We ask better questions. And when we ask better questions, we get better answers and we feel better. And guess what happens? Energy follows thought. Our aura is filled with positive energy. And that brings in more positive energy. Just like when we're grateful, we open to more good and more good. So we can place our hands over our heart and think about the beautiful quote from The Little Prince. The author reminds us, one sees clearly only with the heart. Anything essential is invisible to the eyes. So we take time every day to connect and listen to our hearts. And that starts with loving ourselves first, forgiving ourselves, and knowing that every experience has brought us to this moment. And lastly, I remember going through a notebook that Donna Marshall gave me of her mother's, our beloved Mary Riley. And in the back, I found a picture, and it was a big eye. And under the eye, it said, "See only God." And I thought, wow, that's really powerful. I shared that with our first Power of Eight spirit group back in February. And we all agreed that seeing that way takes intention and attention. So my eyes at this point, one done and one undone, remind me of the predicament of the duality of our lives, being spiritual while having our human experiences to learn our lessons. We can choose how to see. We can stay in that center wholeness. It's very simple, but it's not easy. I work at it every day. And that is why being in a spiritual community is so wonderful, because when we see each other clearly, it's a beautiful gift. We help each other to see more clearly in love. People are reflecting love back to us. And I'll just close with a little story of Reverend Juan when he was here the first time. I was telling him about our Eye of the Storm class and about the donut. I had switched it to the donut in the donut hole. And he said, "Yeah, when you're in the hole, the donut gets sweeter." And I thought that was so adorable, that the life gets sweeter when we are in that whole place, that center, so that we can see clearly. And we see with that inner eye. And so I close with, I see you, and I need you to see me as I am. Thank you.
Thank you, Leslie.
You're welcome.
And we see you. Ways to give. I first want to thank you for your amazing generosity. It's ongoing in supporting our center. My name is Martin Mahalko, and I'm one of your board of trustees. And abundance. We are amazingly abundant in this center. And so I want to thank you for your ongoing giving. And ways you can give is to text the word GIVE to 844-937-1769. Or you can go to unityofvero.org and hit the donate button. You could do that anytime. Or you can send a check to 950 43rd Ave, Vero Beach, Florida, 32960. And for prayer requests, you can go to unityofvero@gmail.com for all your prayer requests. And they are held in confidence. Thank you. And now I'm
doing... And we take our donations.
And we bless
them. And
we
bring them to our hearts. And yes, we now bless them. We do have a basket out there. I don't have my mask on, so I'm going to just step back here. Do the mask dance. We do have a basket out there. You can go to our website and hit the donate button. We just thank you and love you so much for your ongoing support. So let's take our intentions or our donations and repeat with me. Divine love through me blesses and multiplies all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. And we say, thank you, God. Amen.
Amen.
So, you know, Leslie spoke about stepping in to your fears. This was one of my fears. I gotta tell you, I still have a little shaky voice, you know. Plus I broke my glasses, so I'm doing okay though, you know. All right, Leslie also mentioned the labyrinth. But from the labyrinth, you can connect to our amazing path. And we have an ongoing brick campaign, which continues to thrive. This is our third week, and it's a 6-week program. And we're halfway there. If there's sales opportunity, you can go to our website. There's a thing there, a site there where you can fill out the brick and donate. We are also advertising on the path a scholarship. It is available. If you're interested in a scholarship, contact the office.
A scholarship brick.
For the brick. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yes. There are a few words I do forget. Our licensed Unity teacher, Paul Esch, starts his new class, Breaking the Ten Commandments, at the end of April. Thursdays, 6:30 to 8:30, each class stands alone by donations to Unity Vero. See the path for more information and how to register. And thank you, Paul. Our prayer chaplains. Today is Beverly Fieldhouse. Thank you, Beverly. And see her after the service in our chaplain corner for any or all prayer requests. I want to thank you, Aaron Briggs, who continues to make our church grounds beautiful with her vision and hard work. If you haven't been here, and we invite you to come, we are open on Sundays. Mm-hmm. We want to feel your energy. We want to see you here. We have so many amazing seats. Our intention is to see your faces in these seats, mm-hmm. to bring that amazing energy here. And thank you for the flowers on the outside. There are many kinds of ways and opportunity for service here at Unity. Contact the office, create a new way to give. Also contact us if you have any prayer requests. And thank you.
Okay, we're going to finish off service with the peace song. So if you're here, last week I didn't invite you guys to stand and hold hands, but if you want to hold hands within your group, or you can kind of, well, we can't touch elbows because that would still be not social distancing. So hold hands in your group and sing this with me.
Let there be peace on earth and let it begin with me.
Service, and we will close with the prayer of protection. The light of God surrounds us, the love of God enfolds us, the power of God protects us, the presence of God watches over us,
Wherever we are, God is and all is well. Thank you, God.
Thank you,
and
God.
Thank you all for being here today. Bless you and have a beautiful week. Please come back next Sunday.